Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. As always, it is a pleasure to welcome you back to the channel. In today's video, I'm trying something a little bit different. As you can see, I'm playing Grand Theft Auto, and there's a new... Well, I say new, but it came out a while ago. There's this new sort of side mission that you can do in online where you get to be a taxi driver. And so that's what we're going to do today for a while. See if we can't have a little fun with that. Now, I can't guarantee that I'm the best driver, or the safest driver.
Let's go, please.
We're gonna do our best, right? We're gonna do the best we can to get these valued customers where they need to go. And I skipped through like the first couple rides just because I wanted to get the max boost. Because the more of these you do, the more money you make. And it is, I think, like 5 times money right now. So it's honestly, like, not that bad. You get, like, 10,000 something every couple minutes. Which I don't think is the best money maker. All things considered, I don't think it's anything crazy, but, you know, I figured it would probably be the most relaxing way to do it, because a lot of other ways to make money in this game are exceedingly violent, so I'm not entirely sure how relaxing that might be. You'll have to let me know if you know, if you want to see more content with Grand Theft Auto, if you want to rob some banks together, or you know, a rich maniac's private island, despite it getting nerfed significantly, is still probably one of the better ways to make money in this game. But I know I haven't been uploading again. You know, that sometimes that's just how it is, right? You know, life takes hold of all of us. And, for a
Thanks.
While there, I got super busy with other things, but hopefully, and I feel like I say
I've
this
got someone for you.
Hopefully, I'll get back on track here soon, and I'll get more videos out for you guys. One thing I have been thinking about lately is making a second channel. A second channel not dedicated to ASMR, something where I can do some more creative stuff that I've had on the back of my mind, right? I don't really know how to describe the sort of vision that I have in my head.
Let's go, please!
But, you know, just thinking of some content ideas that I have, and the viability of them as sort of traditional ASMR videos, I don't think really fits the creative vision, I guess, that I have for that. But we'll see. The kind of videos that I want to put on this hypothetical second channel would be, excuse me. Goodness me. The videos I would want to put on that require a lot more dedicated time that I haven't really had filmmaking, into storytelling, into stuff like that. I did it all throughout high school. I spent basically every waking moment in high school doing, you know, making student films and that kind of thing. They're still on YouTube. I would never expose myself like that, but they are still out there, unfortunately. I did actually win a couple of awards for some of the stuff I did in high school, and I got some scholarships and stuff that I never actually followed up on, because right after I graduated high school, my initial plan was to just take a year off and work and save up some money, and then I wanted to go to Europe. But
I don't know right now
how many of you were around in the year of our Lord 2019 and 2020, and the unfortunate things that happened in those years that sort of prevented me from going down that path, and I never really picked up with it again, for better or for worse. I mean, the more I really the more that I thought about it, right, I guess the less interested I became doing that as a career, and maybe not really, you know, as a career, but more so like, I don't think I was ready to do that at that age, you know. I don't think I really knew who I was, what I wanted, that kind of thing. So I'm not, like, upset about it, you know. But, you know, it is kind of unfortunate that I didn't get to, didn't really get to follow suit with that kind of thing. I mean, I feel bad for the class after me, though, because they, you know, they didn't get a graduation at all, right? I still had my graduation. But less than a year later, nobody got to have an actual, you know, proper walk across the stage graduation. And, you know, granted, that's not for everybody, obviously, but, you know, just some wild couple of years there. I don't know, you know, it's, life is quite a strange thing. You know, some things are completely out of our control, and, that was just one of them. You know, I could have, you know, I don't want to, like, be too audacious or anything, but, you know, I could have had a lot of opportunities in the entertainment world if I had, you know, started sooner, right? If I had just taken that film scholarship, but... Yeah. I honestly, you know, it's... So, like, looking at your life in that kind of way is... I don't know, it's weird, right? Because it's like, I don't regret not doing it.
Thank you!
You know, like, I've enjoyed the opportunities that I've had, and some of the stuff I've gotten to do.
I got a job going right now.
But, you know, something to think about for sure, I think. But I don't know. It's just one of the stories of my life, I suppose, that I will one day get to tell my children and my grandchildren. Just be one of those things. I don't know how many of you that watch my videos keep up with internet trends and whatnot, but there was a trend for a while where people were talking about dad lore, right? And how, like, everybody's dad just did a bunch of crazy stuff in their 20s, and, you know, you get to hear all about it when you start growing up. And it's like, I wonder, you know, what kind of dad lore I might have, you know, because I'm still super young. I hope, I hope to one day, you know, get to go out and visit Europe again, because I've been to London. I went to London in 2019, my senior year, and I had a lot of fun out there. London is great. I'd love to go back someday, but I, one day I want to go to, like, Spain and Italy and France. I have some cousins out in Germany. I've always been, you know, sort of a wandering spirit, I guess. And, you know, that's part and parcel of why I've named the channel the way that I did. I've always been, even in video games, you know, I just sort of wander about, and I talked about this a little bit in the Minecraft video that I, one of the Minecraft videos I did, where it's just like, I, you know, I can't sit down, I can't stay in one place for too long. It just really, I don't really know how to describe it, but it just, it gets to me, you know, it just kind of bothers me when I'm stuck somewhere and I can't handle it. It's like, I gotta get out, I gotta move, I gotta be other places.
God bless you, and thank you.
A lot of my friends are like that too, and I suppose that's why we're friends.
I gotta pick up not too far from you.
We just need to be
sending you the address
moving,
now.
Moving all the time, right? But, I don't know. To talk more about Grand Theft Auto a little bit, recently they finally confirmed that a trailer for Grand Theft Auto 6 is coming before the year ends. And you know, I don't want to psych myself out, because I feel like a lot of people lately have been getting let down by a lot of the video games that have been released late in, you know, the last couple of months, right? But, man, when I saw that tweet, right, like, I was so hyped. Because, you know, I have, like, 1,000-something hours in this game. I've completed the story, like, 6-7 times.
Let's go, please!
I have almost everything there is to own in GTA Online, and I'm hoping that when GTA 6 comes out, I have no doubt they will reboot Grand Theft Auto Online. But I'm hoping that they don't focus so hard on shark cards, like their in-game currency stuff. And yeah, I think it'd be a really big shame if they do that, because I've loved Grand Theft Auto Online. I really enjoy a lot of the content, but you know, they released Kyle Perico, which was a fantastic heist. I loved that heist. It's how I made most of my money in this game. And it, ever since it got released, it has been nerfed and nerfed and nerfed and nerfed, and it's such a shame, because the way, and you know, I'm not a game developer and I'm not a game publisher, but the way I see it, right, why would you punish your players for playing your game, right? Like, And I get that everything's a live service game now, for better or for worse. But it's like, I feel like having people just play your game consistently and like having a good product is probably gonna make you more money in the long run. But again, you know, I'm not a game developer. I don't publish games. But it just feels to me that it would make more sense that you just eventually make way more money if you just have a quality product. And that's not to say that, you know, GTA is bad. Like, Grand Theft Auto Online is honestly some of the most fun I've had playing video games. Because there's just so much stuff that you can do. You know, I'm pretending to be a taxi driver right now, for instance. But if I wanted to, I could go rob a bank. You know, I could go do some F1 racing. You know, it's like there's all kinds of stuff that you can do in this game, and I really appreciate that. But you know, it gets frustrating when it's like the things you do in the game, when they start to take that away from you, it really feels like you just get punished. And it's a terrible feeling. It feels awful when you do that. And I haven't done the Kyle Perico heist, or Kyle Perico, or whatever it is.
Damn you, devil!
Oh, that was bad. You know, I haven't done that heist since they nerfed it, because it's like, why would I bother? Right? You've crippled the amount of money I can make with that. It's like you're forcing me to either, you know, pick content that I'm not super into, or buy shark cards, and I'm not gonna buy. You know, I'm just not gonna buy shark cards, Rockstar. I'm sorry. You know, that's just not happening. And granted, my rule, and I think this is a very sensible rule, not to toot my own horn, but my rule when it comes to video games has always been, if I spend $1 on a video game, that better be at least an hour of content, right? Like, every dollar that I put onto a video game had better give me an hour of content. So it's like, whenever I see these games come out, and they're, you know, they're putting $70-$80 price tags on them, and then it's like, oh, we've got, you know, 15 hours of content. And it's like, buddy, what are we doing here? What are we doing? And like, you know, I understand, right? It costs money to make video games and whatnot, and you know, the economy, the economics of it, you know, whatever. But it's like, if you're gonna put something out there, right, and especially if it's like DLC or early access stuff, like recently Ark Survival Evolved, which is another game that I absolutely adore despite all of its flaws, and there are many in that game, but despite all that, I love Ark Survival Evolved. I love that game. And recently they shut down all the servers,
and thank you.
And they remade the game in Unreal 5, and, you know, I'm thinking, oh, Unreal 5, there's no way you can screw that up. You know, it's Unreal 5, it's an incredible engine. And, you know, it comes out, and then I bought it on the day it released. They had a 10% discount, you know, obviously trying to tell me that it's good, enticing me with that glorious 10% discount, but I buy it, right? I buy the game, and, you know, my computer isn't the best, right? It's mainly limited by the processor. The processor's a little old, and the RAM could use some updating, but the main thing is, it has a 3070 in it, right? I've got a 3070 in my PC, and Ark Ascended, the new game, the remake on Unreal 5, runs worse than the original, somehow. You know, I spent like an hour just trying to finagle with the settings to get it to like an even acceptable state, and it was just a nightmare. It was a nightmare. And you know, of course, my second rule when it comes to video games is never buy anything first. Never buy anything first. Do not be the first guy to go out and buy a video game, especially in today's market, because it's going to suck. And let me tell you, that was a miserable experience, in my opinion. Luckily, thank you to Steam's beautiful refund policy, I got all my money back. I got all my money back, and, you know, I texted a friend of mine, who is also an avid ARK player. He still has Ascendant. And, you know, one day I'll probably go back and get Ascendant. Probably months and months from now. When they come out with some of the other maps, I'll probably jump back in. But I texted that friend of mine, who's a big fan of ARK, and I said to him, you know, getting the money back was more enjoyable than playing the game. And I think that just tells the entirety of the story. Because, like, I was so relieved to have gotten my $40 back than I was at any point playing ARK Survival Ascended. And it's a shame, right? Like, I didn't want that outcome. I wanted to be able to enjoy ARK on a new engine with new graphics, and the graphics do look good. It's just not optimized, not yet. Maybe it will be. I hope, right? I hope one day they'll figure it out and it'll be optimized and it'll be the game that ARK was supposed to be in the first place. How hopeful am I, you might ask? You know, we can debate about that, right? we can figure that out another day. But I don't know, it was just upsetting.
Thank you.
You know, it was like the first time I've actually had that happen with a video game that I'm anticipating.
I've got someone for you.
I'm just completely let down, and I hope that GTA 6 isn't like that. I don't expect it to be, because Rockstar, especially because, like, the context is that the current GTA Online team is not the team that was on the game when it first came out. It's an entirely separate team, because Rockstar moved a lot of the original assets onto new projects like Red Dead 2, assuming they also moved them on to GTA 6, and that's allegedly, of course we have to say this is all alleged, allegedly that's why GTA Online is sort of falling off, is because it's not the team that started it, and they don't really care in the same way about the game that they did. You know, they're just trying to work it down until the sequel, you know, the next game in the series is out. Which is fine. You know, I've been playing GTA Online for like, how long has it been? Like 6-7 years? Like, it's been a while, because I was there when the Doomsday Heist update came out. I'm trying to think what came out before that. Because I know there were other updates that came out before the Doomsday Heist, but they weren't as big. I don't know, it's not really important, but I've been playing this game all the time. So it's like, I don't feel as bad if a game's been around for a while and it starts to decline. But if a game just came out, and I'm buying the game and it's, you know, unfinished, it's full of bugs and glitches, and that is just wild. That is insane that that happens so often in today's world, I guess. And you know, and this is a topic that I've thought about making like a more detailed, more edited, you know, properly constructed video essay about, because, you know, I'm very passionate about video games. I love video games. You know, I've been playing video games since I was like 7. And it just feels like, and granted, you know, I was playing stuff like Spyro and Skylanders and Minecraft and Wizard 101 and all that stuff, but it feels like back then a lot more stuff was just made to be enjoyable and to make money, because it feels like the games industry has really started to just become so commercialized. And, you know, I know I'm not the only one who feels that way. You know, I know a lot of people might agree with me. You might not, obviously, dear viewer, and that's perfectly fine. You can call me an idiot if you want to. You can say I'm super dumb for thinking these things, but it just feels like games have become just commodified, turned into something that's for making money and less about, you know, being entertainment. But,
hello.
You know, I have hope, right? Because
we've
seen a lot of projects come out that have also been really good, right? We had Elden Ring, and of course I don't play Elden Ring. I've never played a Souls game. Maybe I will one day. Maybe I will. But I've never played a Souls game, but I can understand. You know, I've watched a lot of people play it, and it looks incredibly polished, and I know there were a couple pretty significant, like, game-breaking bugs that were going on for a little while, but eventually got patched out in those games. But, you know, you compare that to something like Ark Survival Evolved, and it's just, wow. People can still make quality products. And it's like, there's another one too, right? There's another one too that really, really irks me, and that's Pokemon, right? I want to do some Pokemon stuff for this channel at some point. I don't know what it's going to be, but I want to do some Pokemon stuff because I love the Pokemon games. I love especially Generation 3. That was the first generation that I ever played, was Ruby. But anyways, I love the Pokemon games. But the newest Pokemon games, Gen 9, right? I've just never been so disappointed in Game Freak than with Gen 9. And maybe some of it is the limitations of the Nintendo Switch. I don't know enough about
the
technical side of that to make a decision.
Call just came in. It's up on your GPS now.
But it really, really just seems like they're throwing in the towel some of these days. Because Generation 9 was, I really struggled to get into it, no matter who I watched play that game. And I didn't buy it, right? I didn't buy 8, I didn't buy 9. I had a copy of 7 gifted to me. I had, I think it was Moon. I can't really remember. But I played Generation 7. I didn't buy 8, I didn't buy 9. And I'm glad I didn't, because, you know, I just was unhappy with the generation. I did get Legends Arceus and the Diamond and Pearl remakes, and I think both of those are good. I do enjoy them. But, you know, I was I was really hoping to be able to get back into a mainline, main series Pokemon game again. And unfortunately, I don't know that it's ever gonna happen, right? Like, Generation 10 is
peace
around the corner at this rate.
Let's get this chariot in motion!
Generation 9 came out. It came out somewhat recently, but I think they do. I think they do Pokemon generations every 3 years or something. It's sooner than you would think it was. It happens all the time. You know, big picture of it, it happens constantly. They're always doing new generations, but I think Generation 10 is closer to being released than not being released, I guess? I don't know. But I'm hoping that, they can do something and, like, bring it back to, some of the other games, because, like, I really loved Black 2 and White 2. I think those were incredible games. I loved the original Diamond and Pearl, Heart Gold. I can't remember what the... what was I? Yeah, okay, yeah, it's... Generation 3 is Ruby, Emerald, Sapphire, and Emerald is probably the best Pokemon game ever. I think a lot of people think that, and I don't want you to think that I'm thinking that just because I'm joining with the crowd. But I really like Emerald, I really like Ruby, you know, like 3, 4, 5, right? In my opinion, 3, 4, 5 is like the best, deep golden era, basically, of Pokemon, I think, is Gens 3, 4, and 5. Like, if you've never played a Pokemon game, and granted, it might be difficult with the way Nintendo operates, but if you can get your hands on a copy of any of those games, and you've never played Pokemon before, I would highly recommend that that's where you start. They're just incredible. They're so much fun. There's so much to do, in Emerald especially, there's a lot. And, like, people say that Gen 3 is kind of lacking, which I understand. There's some stuff that other games have that Gen 3 doesn't, but
God bless
Emerald
you, and thank you.
Is just so good. Black 2 would be my other recommendation.
This is Dispatch.
If you've
I got a job
Pokemon,
going right now.
Emerald and Black 2. I never played White 2, so maybe, you know, if you want to play White 2, go for it. But I don't have the experience to recommend it, so do whatever you want with that information, of course. But whatever. You know, sometimes, right, when I'm making these videos and I'm talking to myself, because, you know, of course, I have to be talking to myself. It's just how video creation works, and I sit here in my little cubicle, my little magic room, where I make videos, and sometimes I think I'm going insane, because, you know, this is not the first take of this video, don't you worry, this is like take two or three, I don't really know, like I'll sit in here on the weekends, and just talk about all kinds of utter garbage, really, you know? And, most of the time, I don't think it makes any sense. I hope it does. I think a lot of it's nonsense. The overwhelming majority of it, I think, is just complete nonsense. You know, I'm losing my marbles. Using my marbles ASMR. Someone's probably done that. Who knows? Who cares if they've that's what sane people do. It's a completely rational thing to do, is to just count marbles for an hour or more. Hopefully, all things going well. Hopefully, I will be back in the saddle. I'll be getting more consistent uploads. Whenever I say, I want to get back to doing this, some utter nonsense, right? It's an absolutely monumentally ridiculous scenario just shows up, and I gotta do it. What can you do, man? What can you do? I think, after all that being said, whatever it was that I did say, if any of it made sense, I really hope you guys all enjoy the content that I make. I hope you you all have fun watching these videos, and I hope I will get to speak with you all again soon.
Sending you the address now.
Thank you very much for watching, and I will say goodbye for now.